right, so I'm doing my research. I have Birds of Indiana, the field guide, which is available at Wild Birds Unlimited. Randy, I found my birds.
Oh, there they are.
I found my page.
Okay.
All right, let me give you a little lesson. It's all about the American robin, and it tells me exactly what I need to do. They build with help from the male. Do you know that I saw that they would kind of take turns helping out one another?
Really?
Feed the little babies?
Huh. So the daddy bird would help mommy bird.
Yeah, he's like, I got you. I got this. Let me go find worms. And then he circled back and then he went and gave them to her.
I wish humans would be like that too.
Right. Hey, that's the way it's supposed to be. All right, so you had a small taste test earlier, but I think you need to get the full effect.
It's delicious.
And the sauce and the crunch. Isn't that so good?
Mm-hmm.
I know. And you said even things that maybe it was like, oh, I guess I'll try it. Delicious.
I didn't really think that this would hit the spot, but it does.
Right. I know. It's
so
good. It's a winner. Winner, winner, chicken dinner, as they say, with crab. Okay, so now we're going to move on to something a little more, what's the word?
It's a little fancy.
A little more fancy.
Yeah.
A little fancy. All right, so you've been at work here.
Yeah, I got a head start, and I start with like a tart pan, and I pack that tart pan with some chopped egg and some chopped onion, and then I do kind of a heavy smear of sour cream and cream cheese. And that's
sour
our base.
Cream and cream cheese.
And those things naturally go with caviar.
All right.
And then I do concentric circles of different rows. The outer row is a char row.
A char row.
Arctic char. And then we have a steelhead row, our next.
Is that the darker orange?
It is, and it's got a little, kind of like a little eye to it as well.
Yeah.
And then I have got an American paddlefish row there. And then I've got sturgeon. I've got the real deal caviar there. Now at the restaurant, we'll do one much bigger, and then we cut slices of it.
Okay.
And then we serve you a slice, and then along with that, we have our garnishes, which go with caviar, chopped egg, chopped onion.
Oh yeah.
I love onions.
Capers.
Oh, and I love capers too. Wow.
And I'll do a small one like this when I'm entertaining, for Thanksgiving or something.
I'm going to get my phone from down here because I want to take a picture of this before we dive in.
I just love this dish. And if I ever want to get on my wife's good side, I bring home a slice of caviar pie.
Really?
And she loves it with a little white wine.
How colorful is this?
Yeah, it's a big hit at the restaurant.
It's beautiful.
So we could do slices or like for a party, you could just have one whole pie.
I'm gonna. Can I take
it?
Can I take a pretty
picture
on TV? This is what you guys are gonna see on social media, on Facebook/Instagram, the gram. You know, you got to put it on the gram, Ran.
Yep.
The gram.
And this
before
is a staple
we dive in,
yep.
Because it's just so pretty. Are you ready? Are you good?
I'm always ready.
He's always ready. Are you? Yeah. You're not afraid of this dish, are you?
No, I don't think so. I'm not afraid of any dish. I could just use this spoon here.
Oh, you can eat with a spoon for sure.
Sure.
Yeah.
Okay, so what do
you
recommend?
I would take a little bit of this.
Okay.
Right here from the outside.
Okay.
Smeared
on the cracker.
Those crackers are they're a little crispy.
Oh,
and then maybe like a little of this on top.
A little bit of the garnish. Yes.
All right, Randy, put a little of that, bit of that on top of it.
You definitely want a little caper.
I was gonna.
Sure.
Yeah. You go right.
That brininess like really works.
Right there. Okay.
Yeah.
Like that.
Yeah, you're good.
Yes.
That's real crispy.
Because I love the taste of the capers. Mm-hmm. I don't want to say a sweetness. Well, what kind of taste?
Brine.
Brine.
Salty.
Yeah.
Very, very good chef.
Thank you.
Here comes Mabel. Mabel wants some.
I'm not going to drop any, Mabel.
Mabel. Mm. Oh, this looks delicious. Is this considered an appetizer?
This is.
Yep. Okay.
So we do slices of it at the restaurant, and people love it.
I bet.
It is good, Amber.
Pretty popular dish.
Look at Mabel.
What about the middle? Should I try some of the middle in there with
that's
it, too?
Stuff. Yeah, that's the
All right, he says that's the good stuff. What is your favorite dish at the restaurant?
Caviar pie is up there.
Is it?
It is, for sure.
All right.
Mm-hmm.
Those crackers are kind of crispy, just a warning.
Get ready, Mabel.
I always feel like
yeah,
I
Mabel's, Mabel. All, Mabel's poised back
Get ready, Mabel's coming to the floor. So. Good, huh?
Oh, wow.
Yeah, it's delicious.
Oh, yeah. Those capers, I'm going to say they make it, but that is just a nice little extra touch in that.
And I'm just assembling ingredients here. I'm not cooking. You can do this ahead of time. It's super easy. It can sit in the fridge, and then you just, like, set it out when your guests arrive.
And it's just so pretty and so fancy. Could you imagine if you made this, brought it to a party? No. I got an eye roll.
My wife would know that something's wrong. Yeah, she knows
What's
me,
up
so.
With that, right? Okay, well, remind us of your hours and where you guys are located, Chef.
Sure. We're Monday through Saturday, dinner only. We open at 5 o'clock, and we're directly east of the Fashion Mall on 86th Street.
There you go. I got full mouth.
Mm-hmm.
Did you? Mm-hmm. Chef Ryan, can you read it? Coming up.
coming up, your chance to win a Holiday World and Splash and Safari ticket.
Woohoo!
Details are next.
Details are next. See,
he's overqualified. He doesn't need that. Way overqualified.